Today I'm going to talk to you the subject called The Power of Faith and Spiritual Authority. The Power of Faith and Spiritual Authority. So, we are going to see how the power of faith and the spiritual authority works. The power of faith and spiritual authority. Welcome. You have authority and power. Did you know that regardless of what others says and do, you have spiritual authority to rise above their action and words? You have spiritual authority. You have faith. Faith is in you. You have power and authority. Remember, the Bible tells us, Abraham, the father of faith, when God told him, Abraham, take your only son, Isaac, to go and sacrifice him. Abraham did not go to ask Sarah. He decided to take Isaac and his servants and good. And he was walking with Isaac without fear, without anything, because he had authority and faith. What he commanded is what he will do. He commanded the servant, his servants, to carry the goods. And he told Isaac, let's go. Isaac was walking with his father. And now, when he was looking the father, he said, Father, where is the lamb we are going to slaughter? Look at that. Isaac was worried and asking his father, where is the lamb? What are we going to slaughter? I see you have goods, you have knife, and who? Abraham, because he was full of authority and power, he told Isaac, shut up, keep quiet. Don't ask me any question. God is going to provide this on ramp. Then he went with that authority and faith, spiritual faith and authority. He laid his own son on the fire. He wanted to kill him, but God provided a way. Isaac did not fight him. He didn't even scream, because those people could come and help him. Now somebody saw in you knife, and he tied you. He wants to put you to dead. You can scream, you can fight. But because of that faith and authority, the authority of faith, spiritual authority, that Isaac could not able to open his mouth and scream and need help, because the servant were there. There was the people who went with him. Especially when Abraham told those servants, don't come with me, stay there. Isaac could scream. He could have fight, but because he had power and authority, spiritual authority, so Isaac could not be able to resist. The Bible says in the book of Job 22, verse 28, the Bible says, hallelujah, thou shalt also declare a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the right shall sign upon the ways. Thou shalt decree a thing, and it shall establish. Thou shalt decree a thing. When you have authority, faith, the power of faith and authority and spiritual authority, you can decree anything, and it will be established. We have been given power by our Lord Jesus Christ, and He has commanded us, use the authority we have been given. Thou shalt also decree a thing, and it shall be established unto thee, and the light shall shine upon the ways. You command anything you want when you have the power of faith and spiritual authority. Look what Jesus did to the fig tree. Because he has power, faith, and spiritual authority. He has the authority. So he commanded that tree to wither immediately. Even Paul, Apostle Paul, we have seen faith working miracles, signs, and wonders. Our God, our Lord Jesus Christ, in the book of Matthew 16, verse 19, the Bible says, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatsoever you bind on earth shall have been bound in heaven, and whatsoever you loose on earth shall have been loosed in heaven. You see, this is the power of faith and spiritual authority. When you have these powers, the Bible says you will rock heaven. There is a person who rocked heaven. When people were playing games, they were worshiping idols. There was a lot of witchcraft. People, they didn't want to hear the word of God. He went and rocked heaven for 3.5 years because it was the power that you have been given. Elijah, the prophet of God, servant of God, God of Elijah, he went and rocked heaven for 3.5 years. The Bible says, Thou said the word, my word, and the heaven was rocked. No rain for 3.5 years. Have the king of Israel tried to chase Elijah to kill him. But Elijah says, come, let's talk. Bring those witchcraft, all of them. Let's see who has power. And the witchcraft were brought. They called their God. They tried, nothing happened. But God of Elijah, who answered by fire, when Elijah spoke one word, the rain came, water came, and the fire came, consume everything there. Because he has the power of faith and spiritual authority. When you have this power, nothing will stop you. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yes, Lord, we thank you, Father. Father, we thank you because you are God. Releasing your faith can change your world. Your faith can change your world. Your faith can change your world. But no matter how great your faith is, you must first release your faith if it is going to change the circumstances that are affecting your negativities. If you can release the word, you can speak the word to change the circumstances that is affecting you in negativity. If you are a person who are so negative, you have to release the word by yourself first. You have to release the faith word to command yourself. You command yourself that you, Christine, hear the word of God. From today, no negative comes from your mouth because we serve a living God who answers by fire. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. Your faith can change your world, but no matter how great your faith is, you must first release your faith if it is going to change the circumstances that are affecting you negatively. Hallelujah. Keep on giving me hearts. I want to see you people, my friends, my dear, keep bringing more hearts. God has not given you dominion over your life, the power and the authority to govern and control, but he has given commissioned you to subdue, to bring law and utterance, defeat those things that are not in agreement with his will of you, for you. When you look at the book of Genesis, the dominion that you have been given, the authority and dominion, the book of Genesis 1, verse 26 to 27, God has not given you dominion over your life, the power and the authority to govern and control, but he has commissioned you to subdue, to bring law and order, defeat those things that are not agreement with his will for you. In the book of Genesis, 1:26-27, the Bible says, then God says, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over the livestock, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creeps on the earth. God has given you power, dominion, to rule all birds in the air, all fish in the sea. God has not given animals to authority, birds to authority. has not given them dominion, but you have been given dominion. You have been given power in the name of Jesus. You have been given faith. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created him, man, male and female. He created them. God made you and I in his likeness, just like him and image, and he gave us the same ability to change things that he has by using the most powerful forces in the known universe. Faith, the absolute trust and the confidence in God's word. Faith. When we have faith, hallelujah. Thank you, my sister. Thank you so much. God made you and I in his likeness, just like him and image, and give us the same ability to change things that has using the most powerful forces in the known universe. Faith. That's why Jesus told his disciples, even if you have faith as a mustard seed, you can bring the mountain and command them to go to the sea. That faith of authority and power, spiritual authority, that is what God is looking. The kingdom of God suffered violent, and violent will take by force. Hallelujah. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, Pastor. Oh, let me see. Pastor Dada, welcome, Pastor. Are you back? Are you back from States or UK? Thank you, Pastor. Welcome. That's my pastor. You need to call me. Thank you, Jesus. The power that you have been given me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. My God, I thank you. Yes, Pastor Dada, welcome. You are back to Toronto. Wow, that's good. Yes. God, we thank you. Yes. You are using the God's kind of faith. As you look at Genesis chapter 1 and Hebrews 11 verse 3, carefully and note how God created everything that exists. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. How did he do it? How he spoke it and believed that his words had the power to change things from what they were, nothing to what he wanted. Light, the heaven and the earth, the ocean, life, mankind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, my Father. Lord, we thank you. And if you look at the book of Mark 11, verse 22 to 23, you can be shocked how faith changes things. Faith and authority. Here, when you have faith, no matter what stands in front of you, look at what Moses, he had faith, strong faith. When the enemy was chasing him, he had the Red Sea was in front of him, and the enemy were coming from following them from the back. He didn't do anything. He said God would provide a way. Risk. The faith with the power is another name called faith risk. You risk faith. You go where zero point. You know God will provide. You have the authority. When Jesus gave example physically for his disciples to know and see that faith can do things. You know, the Bible says, without faith, you cannot please God. God does not work with people who doesn't have faith. You must have faith with authority. That will move mountains. When God asked Abraham, take your son, Abraham did not question God. He had strong faith. He believes God and God. He would do anything not to kill my son, but I will obey what he has said. God can ask you to do something that you will say, no, God, I can't do it. And you will lose your blessing. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The kind that God has, in other words, believe that our words can and I will bring forth the changes we want in our life and bring circumstances and line with the will of God, our life. The faith that God is looking is the faith that can move mountain. He said that as small as little mustard seed, you can move mountain. When you have power, as you have seen, the Bible says, you have been given key. You've been given the key in your hands. Whatsoever you want to lock it, it will close. That's why witchcraft, they have bad luck. They lock people. The children of darkness, they know how to lock people. But we, the children of God, we don't know. We don't know how to use those keys. This is the Bible. This is the word of God. Look at it says, how can the children of the devil have authority? If the child of the devil can lock you, you can't prosper. You can't do anything. They will lock and put their keys in the pocket. And you will suffer. You will do prayer and fasting. You do a lot of prayer. You go to pastor and pastor. Unless the pastor knows how to deal with bad luck. The children of the devil, they use this same. They lock people. The children of the darkness, they know how to use this. But as children of God, we've been given, it is our light to lock the powers of darkness, to lock them completely. They cannot exist when we take the faith and power. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Look at the book of Matthew again. 16 verse 19. The Bible says, I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. And whatsoever you bind on earth shall have been bound in heaven. Anything you bound in heart. So the children of darkness, they know how to bind you. They know how to lock you. And you can be locked. You can be locked down. You can't move. You can't do anything. Unless you know how to deal with this spiritual warfare. Unless you get a pastor who can break that bad lock with the child of the devil has locked you. Witchcraft, they do this very well. I know somebody, he is a witch. And he was telling us before he became a Christian, he can rock you no matter where you go. Nobody will help you to open you. So, as children of God, we have to lock these powers of darkness. We have to rock them because we have been given key. Why did Jesus give us the keys of the heaven? He gave us the key so that we can lock. Look at what Elijah did. Elijah, he understood how to use these keys. He rocked the heaven. He said, you people, you are happy. You are worshiping your idols. And you are getting the powers from the heavens. They were worshiping and worshiping the sun, worshiping the stars. And Elijah says, okay, I will deal something that you will regret. He went and locked heaven. Even Moses, when he went to Egypt, he had to attack heaven. He said, "You no rights. It will be dark 3 days, day and night." Authority and faith. When you have the power of faith and authority, you risk. Moses went to Pharaoh and told Pharaoh, "Pharaoh, let the people go. Let the people of God go." Pharaoh said, "Who is that, your God? I don't know that God." But God has to teach him a lesson so that he released the children of Israel. When he released the children and they made a mistake to follow them, he didn't even fear what happened to his country, but still he continued following them. And they died, all those who were following. So your enemy who is following you, is going to die. They are going to die, all of them, in the name of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you, Father. I'm going to pray right now. Yes, you have authority. You shall have degree. Behold, I give unto you power, authority over serpents and scorpions, demonic powers, over all the powers of the enemy, even Satan, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. This is the Bible, the word of God from the book of Luke 10, verse 19. Jesus said, I have given you power, authority, faith, that nothing is by all means that hurt you. That's why we don't fear. Don't allow the demon of fear to come to your life. That's why you need to declare, you need to pronounce a word in your spirit in your life. Command that demon to be roasted by fire, to be destroyed in the name of Jesus. Demon of fear that makes you to fear things, command them to be roasted in Jesus' name. The Bible says you have been given authority. You have authority. You shall decree a thing and it shall be established. That's the book of Joel, of Job 22, verse 28 to 29. The Bible says, you shall also decree a thing and it shall be established unto you, so that light will shine on your ways. When they cast you down and you say, extortion shall come, then it shall say, the humble person. Then he shall save the humble person. That is what you need. You shall decree a thing and it shall be established in the name of Jesus. Jesus said in the book of Matthew 18, verse 18, truthful, I said unto you, whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosened in heaven. Jesus assured his disciples. He told them, I am now telling you the truth. Truly, truthful, I said unto you, don't worry, you have power with you. You have, including Satan. Satan, you can bound them and chain them. You can chain the devil, the demon that is tormenting you, the powers of darkness that is working against you. You have the power. You bind them and loose them. Because the Bible has given you merit of binding them and loose them. It is your responsibility to take authority and power by faith to lock some stuff. Some stuff, they need to be locked. You cannot be tormented by demons all the night. You don't sleep. Bad dreams. You have very bad dreams. When you go to bed like this, you start war, you start battling, you start fighting, you can't sleep, you can't enjoy the night, you can't enjoy your sleep, you fear even to go to bed. So you have to bind them. Call me, call the man of God, call us, we will help you. We'll stand with you and chain those demons that is tormenting you. We can speak the word. Remember the Bible says, You decree a thing and it will be established. We'll speak the word. We'll decree a decree against the enemy, against the demon that is tormenting you. They are torturing you so much. You have been tortured, even sickness. The devil is disgracing you, putting you disgrace, shame. When you go to sleep, they come and sex you. They have sex intercourse with you. They do you so bad. Sometimes animals. Sometimes different kinds to come and have sex with you. Child of God, you have authority and power. You should not go through this. You cannot be tormented by the demons. You need to enjoy the joy of God. You need to have peace when you sleep. You have to sleep like a baby. You have to dream good dreams, not satanic dreams to scare you. When you wake up, you are terrified. Because we have the authority. We have faith. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I thank God that God has given us this authority and power. It's just a matter of faith. Believe the word of God. Jesus said, believe in me. Anything you ask in me, it shall be. I will do it. And Jesus said, you will do great things than me. Therefore, people of God, God has given us everything. It's up to you to use them or you don't use them. It's just take a step of faith. The power of faith and spiritual authority. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. I'm about to pray. God, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. Yes, Lord, my Father. Lord, you are so wonderful. You are so wonderful, God. Yes, I am from Kenya. Thank you, Jesus. Lord, I thank you so much. We love you, God. We worship you. We thank you, Father. We honor you, Lord. You are a great God. Loving Father, we thank you. Loving Father, we honor you. Oh, you are a Kikuyu. Habari yako? Call me. Where are you from? Where are you right now? Where iko wapi? Hallelujah. Thank you, my sister. Yeah. You can tell where I am from. Yes. God loves you. As the power that you have been given, we have to use them. The authority. Okay, call me. Thank you very much. You are from Norway. Good. What's your name? Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yes, God, you are so good. We love you, God. We thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Yes, thank you, Lord. Sister, thank you, my sister. Fida. Fida, is that what you say? Your name is? Anyway, let's pray. Thank you, my sister. Call me to pray for you. Okay, thank you so much. Let's pray, let's pray, let's pray. And I need to pray. Okay. Yeah, Nico Canada. Nico Canada. Yeah, Nico Canada. Ninaongea kutoka Canada. Mungu akubariki sasa. Wacha tuombe. Mungu akubariki sana. Yes. This is my sister from Norway. She's writing in Swahili and she's talking to me in Swahili. Thank you, my sister. God bless you. Thank you. Thank you so much. Yes, let's pray. My Father, my God, in the name of Jesus Christ, I pray that God Almighty, I'm praying God to activate your faith. If you didn't have faith, from today you will have faith. You will have faith to move. You don't have to serve a child of God. You don't have to lose things in the hands of the enemy. You have to use faith because you have been given a weapon. If God Jesus said that whatsoever you shall bind on earth shall be bound in heaven, and whatsoever you shall loose on earth shall be loosed in heaven. So we loose and bind. The Lord called me from the book of Jeremiah. He called me to build and destroy and to uproot. That's why I don't fear the devil. I have to go for him. If he attack me, I will attack him very bad. You don't have to fear because we've been given power and authority. We have to rebuke him and destroy him. There was a lady who was dying in a hospital. They called me from the hospital. That this person is in a oxygen, is on a ICU. She doesn't breathe. I speak the word of God. I was very angry. I speak the word because the Bible says, is decree a thing and it will establish. I pray that this person will not die, but they live to declare the words of God. I command the spirit of death to get out of that person. I had faith and I believe, and God has to respect and honor the word. And that's what happened. The person was healed instantly, and she was discharged after the following day. The doctors were shocked and they said, this must be God. This must be the power from above. You have heard this testimony. That's the living testimony. I have seen so much stuff happening. Because I have faith and you have faith. So the same faith that we have, we will use it. Father, I pray, activate the faith of your people, my Father. Lord Almighty, I commit your people into your hand. I decree by the power and the blood of Jesus to activate their faith, God. My Father and my God, because of this country, people have abandoned their faith. They don't trust you anymore. They trust materials. They trust other things. But they don't believe in you. God, God my Father, I pray that God Almighty, let them have faith that will move mountain. Let them have spiritual authority and faith in Jesus' name. I pray that God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, every power attacking your faith, make your God, mocking your God in you to lose faith, let this power be destroyed. I command them by the power and the blood of Jesus Christ to be destroyed in Jesus' name. You know, the enemy mocks you, disgrace your God, like what Pharaoh was mocking God. He said, who is that your God? I do not know him. Then Moses told him, okay, you will know him. Yeah? When the enemy is mocking you to destroy your faith, to bring your faith down, tell that enemy you are a liar. I believe my Lord Jesus Christ. I believe Jesus Christ. Jesus will never leave me. Remember Psalms 27. Meditate upon Psalms 27. Mother and father will leave you, but God will never leave you. He will provide. He will provide. He will provide. He has provided for me. There was a time I was in Africa. We didn't have anything. We didn't, and it was Christmas time. I had children. Nothing. But I took a step of faith, believing God would provide. Then I saw a white woman with a truck and full of food and about $3,000. That was a lot of money in Kenya shillings. Sister, the Kikuyu sister, $3,000 times American dollar. How much is that? I become rich straight away because I stand the word of God believing. And there was a lot of food. Up to this time, that woman I've never met her. I don't know where she went, but I believe Ada. And not either. She was sent by God and she was an angel of God. I'm telling you that when you have faith, it will move mountain. When I claim something and it happened, I said, God, I claim this, that is mine, and I believe it. I prophesied about 1 week ago or 3 weeks ago. There's a video I was listening, and I prophesied inside that video. I saw two women. They are going to marry. And I said, June, that is when their wedding will come up. The lady called me today and said that I was the one who said, amen, my wedding is on June. Exactly the way I prophesied. I have been prophesied so many times and things happen like this. I started prophesizing about this USA America, USA election. And I know who is going to be a president of America. I know I'm going to tell you soon. I know who is going to be. If you feel my videos, there's a video I prayed for women. I said, women, the one I did maybe the month of January or February, about women. There I mentioned, I prayed there I mentioned. So if you follow me, you will know exactly who is going to be USA president. So I'm telling you that God is able. When you degree a thing, it will be established. We have powers and authority to remove even the wicked leaders. Satanic leaders, we will have authority to move them. People of God, if you stand in the word of God, the power of faith and authority, spiritual authority, there is nothing will pass you. You can command them to stand still. Joshua prayed the sun stand still until they finish the work they were doing. Yes. You can make the sun stand because you have the power of faith. You don't struggle, you don't worry. You just say, the sun will stand still until I finish what I'm doing. You can command the rain to stop, the snow to stop. Ask my people, where we fellowship, we command the snow. Snow, you never affect our ministry, our prayers. Every Friday, the snow will snow, but Friday, nothing. We command it. We told the crowd like that. We talked to the snow. We said, snow, never try to come on Friday when we have our meeting. And that's what happened. So many people are benefiting Friday because of us. Those people have meetings. I command them. I look at the crowd. I say, crowd, I am a child of God like you. So therefore, let us negotiate and agree. Never interfere with my meeting. And that's what happened. I know. God says our ministry will start slowly, small, but it's going to grow. So many people are calling me from Africa, all over, almost all over the world. They want me to go and study training. As you know, we have, I've studied deliverance, overcomers deliverance, overcomers training school, spiritual warfare training school. And this training, it is a university materials, but I'm going to give you basic one, which is costing you a couple of dollars, but I'm going to give you like a gift. That's why I need a donation so that I can bless you too. You go to our website and look at that training. Join. I am here to train you. Thank you for those who have registered. We started the class 2 weeks ago. It is on. So if you have not registered, come and join. Join us and register. I will train you and give you a certificate and ordain you. Even marrying, if you want to get, if you want us to marry you, can marry you. We can even baptize you. There's not everything we can do. If you are looking for someone to marry you, to baptize you, we are here. So you call us, we can help you. If you are like this sister, she was asking me if I can go to attend her wedding. I said, no problem. Let me know the date you're fixed. So you see, God is able. You don't have to suffer. We are the family. You don't have to suffer alone. If your pastor does not want to marry you or does not follow you, that does not accept the faith you have, come out from the box. Don't stay where you are being pressed. This is a ministry God has given to you, and God will help you. Father, I pray that God deliver your people to know the truth, and the truth will set them free. Lord, I pray that God activate their faith. Let their faith, Lord, my Father, let their faith grow strong and strong in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you. Father, I thank you and I give you all the glory in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, my Father, when the enemy is saying, where is your God? Lord, my Father, let them know that there is God in heaven who answer by fire. Every powers of darkness holding you backward, make you that your faith cannot, it's not there. Let those powers die. Let them be destroyed in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, I want to thank you once again. I give you all the glory. I give you all the honor, God. I thank you and I give you the glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. My sister Treasure, can you pull our website? Light them down so that people can see. You can stop the periscope, you copy the website. It is Overcomers. You start with www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of Jesus. We have our email address. If you want to get in touch with me, call me. Our email address. Yes. I'm going to give you the number. Yes, that is the one. www.overcomersdhministries.blogspot.ca. That is our website address. Then we have, yes, that's correct. Then we have Overcomers email, overcomersdhm@gmail.com. overcomersdhm@gmail.com. Now, my sister in Norway, I'm giving you the number. You can WhatsApp me, you can send me a text. Our cell phone number 647-608-5207. Yes, if you can text me, we can talk. Just send me your text message. Or you can call me. We have our cell phone number is 647-08-5207. That is our cell phone number. We have free number. You can call us. If you are in America, Canada, you can reach us. If you don't have long distance. Like one of my sister was telling me that she can't call because she doesn't have long distance. I told her we have a free line. You can call us. Okay, the number, the cell phone number is 647-608-5207. Nambari ni 6 7 6 0 8 5 2 0 7. Nakurudia hiyo namba ili upate kuisika vizuri. Ni 6 4 7 6 0 8 5 2 0 7. Okay. Umeipata. Asante. Yeah, thank you very much. The free number is 877-241-3420. Extension 101. Yeah, my language is like Spanish. That is Swahili. I was talking Swahili to my sister from Norway. That's good. Yes, that's so good. So, the number, we have our landline number, 905-487-7196. That is a landline number. So you can call me to pray for you, to pray with you. And if you need anything about the training, you can join us. You can reach, the information is in the website. I want to bless you. I want to train you to become a deliverance minister. And if God has called you to the ministry, we are here to help you, to train you, and send you to various churches to practice. Some people are going to Africa the month of July and August. If you want to go to Africa, let us know. If you are going there to do the missionary work, that's how we want to train you. We train you and we send you to go to preach. There's so many places is opening now to send the student there. So join us, we'll train you. If you are not baptized, if you are not born again, we'll lead you to the Lord and you will be born again. We'll help you. Many people have been called. You have been called to preach, but you fear, you are shy. You don't know your call, you don't know your gift. Call me, I will identify your gift. If you don't know that if you don't know your gift, call me, I will tell you what's your gift. Thank you very much. God bless you. Enjoy yourself. See you tonight, tomorrow. And I will be on, I said Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, I will be on for 4 o'clock to 4:30 to 4:30. So I know I will come anytime when God gives me a word. Yes, call my sister. I know I'll come anytime.